Coming up on GET,
we take a look at the new MLS team,
look at updates for the Clayton football team,
and look back at Junior Challenge. Soccer.
But do we know all the facts?
Liv Tennill gives us the logistics on St. Louis's Major League Soccer team.
So, St. Louis got an MLS team, and people are pretty psyched. But what exactly is MLS, and why are they coming to St. Louis? MLS stands for Major League Soccer, and it's a men's professional soccer league, which is the sport's highest level in the United States. If you remember, there was a vote a while ago to fund an MLS team, but sadly, it failed. For a while, soccer fans lost all hope. Then, two prominent St. Louis families stepped up and offered to fund the team. The Taylor family of the Enterprise Rent-A-Car fortune and Jim Cavanaugh of Worldwide Technology got to work on a proposal for MLS. After the vote failed, STL was at the bottom of cities MLS was considering to expand to. But what changed? How did STL go from being the last choice to actually be chosen as the 28th MLS team? One main factor was that the proposal for the St. Louis team included an ownership group that was mostly female. What attracted MLS to St. Louis was if St. Louis was awarded a team, it would be the first MLS team with a majority female ownership. So, what happens now that we've been officially awarded a team? The next step is to build a stadium, which will take a while. The stadium is set to be built near Union Station in downtown West. And while the stadium is being built, the team needs to figure out a name. Even though they don't officially join the league until the 2022 season, there's plenty to get excited about until then.
It's homecoming time.
What does that mean?
Football.
Adam Schmidt gives us a look into the football team.
Just Clayton sports in general, they're going up, and I want to be a part of that, even if it's only for 1 year. So, yeah, I would say the energy's increasing, the desire to win, and the determination to work at it is going up. I've seen people just really giving it their all, whether that's in the weight room, on the field, even just when you're talking to a teammate, people are really invested.
Our head football coach spent a lot of time at Wydown during the spring season of last year. Visiting kids during the lunch periods, seeing kids in the hallways, and just selling his brand of Clayton football. I really feel like that's the number one reason why our numbers have increased, is just him being over there connecting with the kids before they got over here, made the decision if they wanted to play football or not.
I think that last year we really set the tone that it doesn't matter how many players we have, we can still have a decent season. I think that us having 20 to 30 players surprised a lot of people, and that the whole entire team did a very good job recruiting.
I know Coach Verby and Coach Schwent both teach in the building, so they're constantly interacting with students and promoting football and talking students into playing football and telling them how it'd be good for them, it'd be good for the team, good for the program. I feel like all those things together are why our numbers are up.
Every day I always, like anybody I think that's built for football, I always poke at them saying you should play football, you should come out to a practice, because just having bodies is what a football team needs.
Well, you have subs, you have people who can come in, give you a break if you're a player that plays both sides of the ball. You can get a break, get some water, and get back in refreshed.
I would say that teachers and then like friends have definitely helped me realize that this is something I'm really interested in and I've always wanted to do. My fellow classmates were active in getting me and my other friends who've never played before.
I think it's the atmosphere, the friendships, the bond you make on the football team. is stronger than any other bonds I've had from playing sports.
11 players out on the field that all have to be accountable for each other. So that, you know, at first makes football stand out different.
There's something about football, just like the community in general, it's a lot stronger. It's more of a family than teammates. The teammates get closer, they spend so much time, so much energy working together and working for each other. It just builds this family, and that's why I really joined.
It's that whole, yeah, the whole entire deal of brotherhood, to where you for sure know that somebody to the left of you, to the right of you, has your back throughout that whole entire game.
I've played football for a month now. It's different. This idea of like brotherhood, friendship, and then loyalty, I've never seen it in another sport, and that's kind of what's bringing me to football and making me love it so soon.
Do you like juniors? Do you like challenges?
Do you like watching juniors do challenges?
Ashton Belzer takes us behind the scenes of Junior Challenge.
I think that these kinds of events, like Junior Challenge, provide a way for students to feel a little bit more connected to a tradition, a feeling like, hey, this is something we've done for a really long period of time, and it makes you feel like you're part of a community.
The main goal is to take the class of juniors and get them out of school for a day, but to get them to actually talk with each other and have some fun and not be in a classroom where the bells are ringing and sending them from one station or one class to another class to another class.
I mean, it's just a really nice way to switch it up from the day-to-day of, you know, regular school. And it was nice. I love being outdoors. I love being with the grade, so it was nice.
It also gets people to loosen up a little bit who might be a little bit tight-laced. So kind of seeing folks out, you know, doing a balance beam and you know, wearing bandanas and stuff makes people loosen up. Being in a park and, you know, in the middle of the day and having sandwiches. All of that provides a sense of community that for a lot of students really matters. But I also really enjoy seeing them kind of out of the classroom and doing something, as I said, just a little bit out of their comfort zone. Something where they're not, you know, really in a huge risk, but also it's some place where it pushes them a little bit. And it's a different way, you know, it's not, here's a test and fill out these bubbles. So I enjoy that.
Well, I had a really good experience with it last year. My group was a lot of fun, and you know, the teacher that was with us was also really fun to be around. So I figured that I wanted to try and help to make this year fun for the other juniors as well. And you know, it's just a fun day altogether.
The senior leaders were great. You know, they were really helpful through all the challenges, and they made it fun.
I volunteered to be a leader for Junior Challenge because I wanted to be set as like a good example for the underclassmen and also show them that actual Junior Challenge was fun.
This year was kind of weird with it being at Shaw Park for the first time because we had a conflict with getting enough buses, and it actually worked out really well. So I think that is probably the future. What we'll do is keep it at Shaw Park because it does have a lot of those built-in advantages. But it's really just hopefully a fun day that the kids really enjoy.
That a lot of the students who I've talked to over the years with it really like the outdoors portion. They like doing activities outside. But I'm wondering if there's something that we could do in the afternoon portion when it gets kind of warm, where we could bring students in together and try to build something that's more every year with a similar group of students to really, again, bring home a small group of community that students can connect with.
You haven't noticed,
it's homecoming week.
Adam Schmidt gives us a look back on the week.